What's up? What's up? This is day 260 making Songbringer. And today's goal is, well, for some context, lately I've been making everything data driven, and that's been awesome. But I would like to take a break from that. It's kind of been really strongly in the programming side of things for a while, so I want to take a break from that and do something where, this can be pretty interesting, where, whoa, this guy's going so fast, where Jib gets scared of the bosses. So if there's ever a boss around, Jib is totally going to get scared of him, run away. And the goal is actually to get him, man, that guy kicked my ass. Anyways, the goal is to get him to actually fight for you sometimes. So if you start getting hurt, Jib will try and distract the boss or whatever. So that's kind of his way of fighting, is he just like annoys a boss. And it can also be a strategy when you're playing as Jib in the local co-op mode. What's up, PETA? Bit of Barney. How you guys doing? It's still Friday for most of you guys, I think. Happy Friday. Yeah, so I'm going to make Jib run away from bosses. And I think the first thing to do is, well, there's two things. One, I want to make bosses or enemies in general aware of Jib so they can target him. Secondly, I want to make it so Jib will run away from the bosses. So I think I'll start with the second part first. Right on, man. Yeah, I'm good. It's a great day. Had a nice morning. Got some code finished, and now I'm ready to kind of do something really creative here today. So, yeah, let's start with Mood Jib. Man, I love that command. This find fast command is so rad. I can't believe I didn't have that in my arsenal until recently. Jib stream. Yep, it's a Jib stream. Okay, so he's got targets. So I'm looking at this code going, okay, how can I simplify this into something that can be reused? So right now he moves towards his target, which is the player. So the goal now is to make it so that's more universal, so it can be applied to bosses and enemies as well. Working on Jib, get him to scare, be scared. He's the scaredy Jib. All right, so it looks like he already has targets. They can be flexible too. So is there anything that sets a target other than the player? Oh, right, he does have this where he moves towards unscanned foes. Okay. Give him some time out. Okay. So I'm going to simplify this bit. Into this is kind of its own method now. Oh, player yid. There. Okay, so now that's kind of its own block of code. This is a bit of code that finds the nearest unscanned foe. There's something else that does nearest. Behavior nearest, that's right. All right, so this is a little bit of code I'm going to turn into a smaller function, because right now what it does is it lists all the entities that are, this is a bit of code here for the behavior system, and it lists all the entities based on either a target mask or a string value of profile type, and then it goes and it finds the closest one. So finding the closest one could actually be a method of position component or collision system. Actually, collision system, no, this could be either way. Yeah, so there needs to be a function which takes a list of IDs and returns the closest one. Position component, I'm thinking, might actually be an okay place to put that. All right, let's do it there. I can also put it on collision system, but no, collision system isn't right. Move system, no. Okay, yeah. Position component, that's where we'll put this. So position component dot h. Let's add a static method, find closest, and we pass in a vector of IDs, and it also needs to be to a certain ID. I hear you, man. You should see the very first video game I ever wrote. I was 14 years old when I wrote it. And it was the messiest code I've ever coded in my life. It was all in one file. We're talking like at least 10,000 lines of code in one file. And it was all written in C. And it was for DOS. And I lost it. Yeah, I actually lost that code. It probably was a subconscious effort on my part to forget how bad of a coder I used to be, I'm sure. But yeah, that was funny. Okay, yeah, we can just give it a position to be close to. Yeah, okay. So find closest id to position, const e3f ref to pause, whatever. There. Okay, so all I will do is list all the IDs and find the closest one. Yeah. Nice, right on. Cool, man. Good for you. There's another guy on here on the stream. His name's Rocket Bunny. He's also really, really young. And then, man, there's been several other people here that have watched these streams that are also very young. I'm very excited to know you guys, because it really takes me back to my time when I started coding. Yeah, 10,000. It was probably more. I mean, look at this project. This project's already, this game I've been working on a year, and it's got 40,000 lines of code. So yeah. You'll get there, man. Don't worry about how long your projects are or whatever. In fact, think of it this way. The less code you have, the better, because there's less to maintain. So, I mean, if this were a perfect world, I would hope that would be more like 20 or 30,000 lines of code to do the exact same game. And I can work on that by making things more data driven, and I've been doing that this whole last week. But really, so yeah, really, code is not, you shouldn't be proud of having lots of lines of code. So, you having a project with only 300 lines, I'm almost jealous of that, you know? That's pretty awesome. I wish this project was only 300 lines of code. It would be amazingly easy to maintain, but it would be impossible to do this kind of game in only 300 lines of code. Well, I say that, but then somebody out there is probably going to prove me wrong and create some whole game in only 300 lines of code. Well, if you're that person, please contact me. Like if you're watching this in the future, please rub it in my face. I would love to see a game written with really, really low lines of code that's awesome and complete and stuff. What's up, Pedro? Welcome to the stream. Welcome to day 260. Today I'm working on making Jib get scared of enemies. And also, enemies are going to be aware of Jib. So they might sometimes attack, try and attack Jib. Or whatever. What's up, Arcane? Welcome to the stream. So it's looking through all the IDs. It's using the position that's given it. Ooh. All right, yeah, I hear you. Good for you, man. What's up, J2? Welcome to the stream, man. I'm making Jib get scared of enemies right now. Id, yeah, that should be okay now. And then id, closest is closest id greater than zero, return. Oh, whatever, return. Closest to it. There, so now this is a safe function because if there's no entities to loop over, it's going to just return zero. Oh, whoops. What is this, backwards day? Had id and id's messed up. Switch, swapped. Dyslexia. This also is safe. It's safe to get at any kind of entities. And our read-only data is safe, basically. All right, yeah. Yep. This looks good. Okay. So now going back to let's do this whole search. Let's do closest id. See if there's anywhere else where I'm doing this. Yeah, so of course there's here. Let's do cl now closest id is going to be position component find closest, and we're giving it the potential IDs and the position is going to be this entity's position. All right, so now we don't need to do any of this. We can just go if closest IDs target that id. Wait, what's this sorted vector? Don't think that's necessary. Wow, we didn't need that. Who knew? Okay, there. That is much simpler. Using basic functions, very cool. Always a cool thing to take a function, make it shorter. Make it more reusable, you know? Meow. What's up, Pro Tito? Help me say your name right if I'm saying it wrong. Welcome to the live stream, man. Day 100, 260. You're here. You're here. Okay, so now I've got that working. Find target nearest is something that happens all the time. So if we go here into this cave and fight this guy, it's gonna use this right away. So. All right, so that's good. And let's go save the position. Yeah, we're gonna do that. Bro Tito, all right. Okay, so now we can reuse this whole find closest thing with the jib. Move jib. All right, so instead of all this, there's going to be a lot less code here because we can simply loop over all. Oh, wait. There we go. So AI target checking that these are. Okay, so I can make a list of all the entities. Vector id. Unscanned foes. Get the render. So we're going to loop through over every single render component. And if it has the render unscanned flow foe flag, we'll push it back into the unscanned foes. And oh, but this is also based on the render sprite position, not. Oh, damn. Let's make sure. Okay, so this is based on the position component, not the render component. Need to make sure that when it kills an enemy that's in health system. When it removes components, see, it does remove the position component. Damn. Ah, just wrote this whole reusable method. Now it's not even gonna work. I guess we could make it. All right. Yeah, we could make this position component find smarter. Oh, thanks, Beta Barney. Cheers, man. I appreciate you wishing me good luck on that. There's a lot of other games at that competition that are probably gonna win it from what, I mean, it sucks for me to put it that kind of expectation on it, but I've looked at every other game and there's some really good ones there that have huge teams. We're talking like 10 people working on this indie game, and it's like VR technology and super duper. It's like a practically a AAA game. But built with like 10 people or whatever. So I'm like, dude, they're probably gonna win it, one of those games. But little old me might, who knows, I might take in the 10K prize. That would be rad. But other than that, it doesn't really matter because it's just the point of going to that is to get it out there, to demo the game and show it to people live in person and connect with people, so in person. So I'm excited to finally be at an actual trade show and, going to an event and sharing this game live with people in person, and also being there to meet other indie game developers. That's gonna be fun too. So, if anybody's wondering what the hell we're talking about, it's Indie Cup, Whippering Indie Cup. I'll post a link. Indie Cup. whippering.com. And tickets are free too. It's in San Francisco on December 10th if anybody's here. Look at that. That's pretty awesome. I know, yeah, if they took into account team size, that would be a huge thing for me. But yeah, we'll see. You know, this could very well surprise me, and maybe I would win. That would be awesome. That would be cool. That would be really cool. Solo developer competitions. I've met a lot more solo developers since I started sharing this game. You know, I started becoming more aware. There's a lot of other people out there. Like, especially one I really look up to is Thomas Happ, who made Axiom Verge. He did all the music, all the code, all the art himself. The only thing he didn't do is business, but nobody really cares if who does the business, you know, except for other business people. Okay, we got to make this that function I just created smarter. So, position component, find. This thing needs to know. Yeah, it needs to know if a render component's position, if it doesn't have one. What's up, Lime? How's it going, man? Where you at? Where you at with your game? Everybody, Lime Studios just got his game greenlit, Project Arrhythmia. Okay, so we'll go. Oh yeah, so we'll do it this way. We'll get the position component, and if it doesn't have it, we'll get the render component. So if it has this position component, so is empty. Position is empty. If it's not empty, then the P is going to be position.pause. Else, we'll grab the render component. Yeah, you struggle with the music? Yeah, well, if you're struggling with music, just do it more, you know? Unless it's just not your thing and you don't want to do it at all, and it's just you hate it or whatever. But if you have that desire to make music, just keep making it, and it'll get easier. You know, start with beats. Start with simple tempo, timing, just a kick and a snare is all you really need. And then try and add a simple little melody to that kick and snare. And dude, you'll be making music in no time. Yeah, it's true. It's true. Nice. Nice, dude. Yeah, this is huge right here. It definitely takes some work to start an LLC or a corporation or whatever for your game. And this is very much underestimated how important that can be for your game career, your business, everything. All right. Okay. So if this is empty, then we're going to grab the position is going to be entity get render component dot sprite dot get position. What? Oh. There. Get position over kid pixel. There. Cool. Yeah, I'm working on Jib right now. I'm making it so Jib will be able to get scared of enemies, and also enemies will be able to track and attack or try and attack Jib or whatever. So this should be pretty fun once this all this code gets done and stuff like that. This should be a pretty awesome thing to bring Jib more to life. You know what I mean? Right now he doesn't really like when you're fighting an enemy like this. If I go back, if this code still compiles, no, he's not gonna be able to die. He's gonna be invincible, but I think he is gonna be able to get hit by enemies. So, oh yeah, I gotta finish this code really quick. But well, no, wait, I do have this command. I think that I can just run the game. Oh yeah. Okay, so right, let's watch him when I fight this enemy. He just, if you focus on Jib, you'll see that he's really not. He's not doing anything. You know, all he's doing is focusing on you. He's completely unaware that there's an enemy in the room, which is not very realistic or lifelike at all. So the whole point is to get him so he's more interested in what's going on. And dude, how did that guy get like he's a stone cold killer. All right, so mood Jib, right? Yeah, finding a nearest unscanned foe. We push back all the unscanned foes. Now we should be able to find the closest one. Closest id equals position component. Find closest unscanned foes. And the closest to Jib's position, which is E dot position dot pause. Render. Yep. Okay. Yeah. So all right, so if closest id is greater than 0, we can set it to Jib's target. Not sure that this line of code is necessary anymore. Yeah, definitely. Boogie! Hey guys. Hey guys, what's up, guys? Hey, welcome. Oh, and now we don't need this either. I know this is looping over all render components, so we don't need to check that. There. And this might not be necessary. Mike, what's up? Welcome to the stream. I'm making Jib get scared of enemies right now. I want to turn off the fire sword. We're not using that right now, and there's a bug with it. And let's put the player back at 0 so we can kill some enemies, scan them, and make sure that that's all still working. Yes, he is. He's getting an upgraded AI module. So at first, Jib is going to have no abilities or whatever, except that he can annoy enemies. That's like his only. He can distract and annoy enemies. That's his only thing he can really do, right? He can move, and enemies can be attracted to him, so he can distract them and annoy him that way. So that's Jib's first ability, but later on he will have circuit boards and other types of things and upgrades he can get, which maybe like give him a tiny weapon or a stun or something else. But all in all, he's gonna be a very much of a support character. Okay, yeah, this looks like the unscanned foe is still working, but he didn't find any items there, so let's make sure that he can find an item. Oh yeah, he's found some items. All right, good job, Jib. And you're still working. Yeah, emotion chip, yeah. Stream delay's low? All right, it's about time. Thanks, man. Laser, yeah, like pew-pew lasers for sure. Because he's tiny. He's tiny. He's definitely going to have some pew-pew lasers. Yeah, this is impossible. That's not necessary anymore. Okay, so now we got some shorter code there. Okay, so now we can do this a very similar thing. Find the nearest enemy. So if we still don't have a target, other than the player, then we're gonna look for all the enemies. Right. Yeah, so what I did, I upgraded to the newest version of Game Show and reset all my settings or whatever. I talked to support from their company, so hopefully there's not as much crashing going on. That said, I did do that yesterday, and the stream was about to crash by the end of the stream yesterday, so I don't know what it was, but Game Show is just, sometimes it used a lot of CPU. But then there's also the other crash. There's two crashes that can sometimes happen. One's with YouTube. Okay, so the next thing is to go and look for all the enemies. So there's collision system Gideids. What's up, Anoanet? Welcome to the stream. Today I'm making Jib get scared of enemies. So this is where it will... Oh, it will grab... Oh, this is what I want. Yeah, yeah. We can use Gideids with the category. Great. This is unscanned foes. Here's foes. So, and collision system. Gideids. For Eid, which is Jib. Mask, we're looking for K filter foe. So find all the foes. And then find the nearest one. All right. Whoa, dang, Pandaliti. New Zealand, huh? He's invulnerable. Yeah, he's always going to be invulnerable. Mm-hmm. I'm thinking, let's keep that open. Maybe not. Maybe not. Maybe Jib will have hit points. Also, once we get all these targets... Let's push back the player. Man, I don't know what happened, but something happened recently and now it autocomplete is so slow. Whoa. I don't even know what mine is. Yeah, this doesn't need, I don't even need to do that either. So e.ai target equals, there's already some code in place to check if it's zero and put it back to the player. So there. So this will set Jib's target to a foe if there's a foe closer than the player. And let's see what happens. Yeah, speed test. Yeah. That's right, man. Australia is the West Island. The West Island of New Zealand. Yeah, look, Jib's totally following that guy. Get him, Jib. You don't want to scan anybody? There's foes to scan around here, buddy. Oh, well, as long as there's an enemy on the screen, he doesn't scan them anymore. So really, he should do this first. Really? What's mine? Let's do this for science. Is .NET. Begin test. I am streaming right now, uploading 2 megs a second. So I don't know what that will affect. But I think we have pretty good internet here in the Bay Area. He does. Download 73. Pretty nice, huh? The upload's pretty badass too here. I wonder what it'll get. Looks like around 6. Oh, does it say it? Oh, it does say my IP. This is probably bad. Oh, it was? Am I down? Did I just down it? Yeah, reconnected. Nice. Okay. It looks like what happened was game shows like, oh my god, something's using all the internet. And then it just reconnected. All right. We're back. But for science. It was for science. Okay, so let's see what happens when Jib's when Jib is near a boss. Get him, Jib. Yeah. So he doesn't want to follow me at all. Even if I get close to Jib, he doesn't care. What the heck happened? That guy's like 10 times as hard now. Yeah, right. Yeah, we do a lot of streaming here in this house. So, yeah. God damn, Beta Barney, whoa. So, what's first things first, huh? But what's the first thing? Do I fix the boss so he's not as incredibly hard? I probably should, huh? So this Roz mini boss guy. Yeah, he gets created from the story system. Let's fix that. This first. Here it is. He teleports in, create the AI. See, it might be this that it's creating with. Well, let's just find out. I want to see what kind of intelligence this guy is ending up having and all that. Oh, no, that's a good idea, Azarus. Huh. I like that. Yeah, if Jib did have hit points, he could go into some kind of power saving mode or something like that. Yeah. I like that. I like that. So, okay, the plan I have in my head so far is that Jib is going to once you start fighting this boss, Jib, there's sort of a story sequence built into this first boss fight in that Jib, once he sees that you're getting hurt from the boss, he goes and tries to distract the boss, and then the boss hits him and Jib falls to the ground, he's stunned. And you're like, oh no, Jib's dead. But then he wakes back up and he's fine. So, but then from then on, you understand the fact that Jib has the ability to distract and or annoy enemies. Yeah, right. I'm repairing icon. Okay, so I think something happened here in this method, create AI, that is making it, making this enemy incredibly hard. Let's find out if that's for real. So his intelligence is starting at one. Difficulty's what? Intelligence one, difficulty one. Make him a terrorist. There's a bit of code where it amps up an enemy's hit points. I want to make sure it's not doing that with this guy. Oh, it's his. Oh, it's his hit points actually. This only happens in the Roz enemy, Roz boss. This guy, he goes into this mode where he's super fast. Charge, here it is. Oh, okay, I can just pay attention to before I step into all that. He's like, Wally. What if boss eats Jib and your mission is to free him? That's kind of cool, J2. Hey, what's up, T? Is there a baby? Oh, right. I want to turn on. it is only charging when... Dude, he's way fast when he's charging. Oh, you know what? He might be charging. I want to see this speed too. Speed 2, what would that do? AI system. Ah, yeah, you know what? I shouldn't be doing this right now. But let's find out. Behavior speed. Oh, yeah, that just gets set. Right? Yeah, that boss guy, I remember him. Dodongo? I think it's Dodongo. Yeah, Teak, right on, man. Ooh, cool logos, man. I think, oh man, I don't know. I kind of like this one. But these ones are all kind of cool too. All very, very classy, man. Very classy. You want a grappler upgrade? Oh, that's cool. Jib can pick you up. No, please. Yeah. No, it's not a huge effort at all. Yeah, Mike, please. Send me an email and just let me know what you want your name changed to. Absolutely. And that goes for anybody. Anybody that wants to change your name in the credits or whatever. There's plenty of time to do that, and I'm absolutely happy to do that. No problem. So just email me. That's right. Yeah, I don't know why this guy is so hard all of a sudden. I'm not going to worry too much about it, though. Let's go back to Mujib. Mujib. Okay, so he never ever stops following an enemy. Which he should. He should. Yeah, he kind of needs to scan every single enemy every single frame. I think that's the way to go with him. Yeah, nice. Pixel skills going up. Good for you. Oh, is this like a comparison? Upper is old, lower is new. Oh, yeah. Good job, man. Good job. Yeah, all right, let's make him scan everything every time. So he always gets some new targets that he always... Find a new target. Always do this. And then we add on the unscanned foes. So we always have the player, foes, unscanned foes, everything. And we just always find the closest one. Cool idea. Yeah. All right, see what happens now. Hopefully he, this time I want him to be able to track the player. If the player is closer than the enemy, then to start following the player instead. Jim, no, don't go following him now. Jim, follow me now. You know you want to. Oh, dude, you want to. Right here, buddy, right here. Nothing. Awesome, buddy. All right, what happened here? What happened? This, all right, let's figure this out. Let's start dividing and conquering. Yeah. I got that as a warning. I got to get that fixed. He can see the future. Was it the filter foe? I mean, I'm not sure exactly what it is at this point. Yeah. Is using auto in C++ considered best practice? That's a really good question. The stream's dead again? What the hell? Alright, so now Jim's following me. We're back. I know I shouldn't. That was a bad move. Yeah, it looks like it disconnected, but it reconnected automatically. Because now it says my stream has only been up for a minute. But yeah, so you were asking, Artemis, what's up, man? You're new to C++, you're wondering about auto and best practices. What's up, Weedabit? Let's see if I can, there's an article out there about this, because I have my opinions, but I think you getting an opinion from more people would be better in this case. If you're wondering about best practices, here you go. Here's some good links. How much is too much with C++ auto keyword? But if you're wondering about my opinion, I think it's great to use it all the time, personally, as much as you possibly can, because it's, in some cases though, it might be less readable. So it's a readability decision, right? And it's also a maintainability of decisions. I think sometimes using auto can make things more maintainable because let's say I changed the return value type of this function right here. I would want this to be auto so that automatically it would actually it depends. It depends on how I'm using this. Some cases I would want this to be auto so that it would take on the type of this function. Other times I would want it to be specific, like okay, I'd want that to definitely be an integer. Or I want that to definitely be a vector too, or whatever. So it depends on readability, the way you're using it, and then a lot of things. And I hope those links help. All right, this doesn't make any sense. If I add this. Now we have the player, and we also have foes, any foes on the screen. And it's going to go ahead and find the closest one to Jib. And so if I add this and I run this again, Jib should follow me if I'm closer than the enemy is. So if it doesn't do that, we need to check out. Oh, no. Jib, don't do it. Don't do it. Oh. Jib. Oh. Nope. He's not doing it. All right. Hey, what's up, Ladder Thief? Lighter Thief, I'm making Jib so he can annoy enemies and he can get hurt by them sort of. I'm kind of on the fence whether he actually gets hurt or not. And also enemies are going to be able to target him pretty soon too. So he's going to be a lot more interactive with enemies. Probably best if this find closest function. Outputs something like, hey, let's put out some data to the log. Jib time. Yeah, you should, yes. Protito, I'm using 3.7 right now. I did upgrade to 3.8 and then there's a couple bugs or something. I didn't work on it anymore. Yeah, here we go. So distance. Find closest. We'll grab this thing's name. And say how far away it is. Entity get. Dude, I gotta type everything again? What happened to the autocomplete, like being snappy? Rip again? Somebody DDoSing me? How could I tell? Is there some way I can tell if somebody's DDoSing me? It could be a DDoS. It could also just be Twitch, you know. This is usually a usually happens. Jeez. 30 seconds later. Okay, get title. And dist. There. Oh, yeah. Right? Standard DDoS would be like a ping flood or something like that, right? So why wouldn't I be able to connect if I was DDoSed for 5 to 15 minutes? I'm trying to understand what the latest form of DDoSing is. All I'm familiar with is ping floods. Okay, so this is gonna give me some data on this whole get find closest function. Because this should be happening every single tick for Jib. And he shouldn't do. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy, follow me. Mommy, look, a programmer. Don't look at them, Ricky. I don't want you to be influenced by. Oh, God, no. Printf. It's too late, mother. I've seen everything. We wear glasses because we can't see sharp. Yeah, this is exactly how I learned to program. It just all hit me like that. Bapu! Definitely spitting image. Okay, let's check the console. Look at that! Roz mini boss 59, rock 29. Hold on, I do have to go and say, all right. Closest is. Oh. All right. Oh, it's not working for you. Dude, don't tell me it crashed again. No, we've been up for a whole 4.5 minutes. Don't we all? I just want to watch in peace, man. Let me be. Jib. He doesn't care. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Welcome to the stream, man. I'm working on Jib being more interactive. He's going to be able to annoy enemies, and also enemies are going to be able to target him and stuff. Oh, you know what? Look at this. Look at that. Oh, I know what it is. I know exactly what's wrong. So the... The find closest id. Oh, geez. This is such a simple thing. So this thing, it was working fine. The problem was that in mood jib, Well, not in Mujib, but in collision system get eids, it resets all the eids. So I shouldn't be doing that. That's just dumb. Yes, right. Are you late? No, man, you're right on time. Yeah, there's Paceman. What's the other one? Profile system get eids. Both of these. Neither of these should clear eids. Collision system. Get eids. Don't clear. Now I just need to make sure. Oh, name component, same thing. Don't clear. Now I just need to make sure that everywhere I'm using get eids, it's starting off with a clear list of eids. It's already empty. Yeah, see, that would be fine. It's already empty. Yeah. Yeah, gist is pretty awesome, but it's more for like something that you want to share over and over and over. Pastebin is, I guess, more for like, something you want to share once. I guess, I don't know. What am I, the internet know-it-all? There, that's good. That's already zero. That one's already empty. That one's already empty. That one's great. 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 There. Bug should be fixed now. Famous last words. Mujib. So now we should be able to do all these at once, all these entities. We could even have duplicate entities in here and it'll be fine because we're going to find the closest one and the closest one's always going to be just as close as it is to itself or whatever. So this should work. This should work. Need help coming up with an enemy? Oh. So your world has mutant animals. Why don't you make a mutant animal? Jib, follow him. Follow him. Yeah, good job, Jib. Now follow me. Follow me. Yeah, buddy, come on. Oh, no, don't follow him. He's confused. Oh, this guy's a stone cold killer. It's tag. You can't decide how to draw it. This is where that dude. This is where the creativity of game development happens. Right there, in the moment that you're in, man, is deciding how to draw something. Is being. What excites you? What excites you to draw, man? What would be the coolest thing you could draw right now? It doesn't have to look great. It just has to be what excites you. Jib glitched out from too many targets. Oh wait, let's make sure he still can scan foes. No, we're stuck in here. Mutated unicorn. Okay, now he's following an enemy. Let's make sure that if I go off screen, he comes back on. Oh yeah, okay. Because the entities, of course, have died. Oh, see, unscanned foes need to be a higher priority. Higher priority than anything. Yeah, okay, let's make that happen. So it first he looks for unscanned enemies. And if eids.size hasn't been filled, then we push back the player and any foes. Yeah. Put 20 entities in a perfect circle and Jim in the middle. What would he do? I don't know. All right, Anoa. See you, man. Final Fantasy 12, what was that AI system like? Yeah, buddy. This is so great with them following enemies. Oh, the other guys looks like they wandered off the screen forever. Oh, look at this. This area has no floor. Yeah, totally. Right? Conditions, yeah. Really, what I should be doing is making this whole, all of his AI run off of the behavior system, but it's kind of nice to have him not do behavior system. Yeah, lasers for sure. Yeah, lasers. Somebody else has suggested that Jib should have a sword, like a tiny mini sword. And whenever you swing your sword, he swings too. Yeah, there's shops, man. There's shops, there's dungeons, there's gonna be NPCs as well. You like it? You like this? You like the lasers? I like the lasers too. I think it's gonna be an item that you get, right? It gives him some kind of attack. And I think it will be a stun. Like his laser actually stuns enemies very, very short at first. And then you can maybe get an upgrade for his stun or whatever. Throwing knives? Yeah, Lime. Rocket Bunnies is pixel art. Rocket Bunny, you should send your screenshot over again and so for context. Ooh, he drags a balloon around? And it can pop? That'd be funny. Game of the year? In my dreams, maybe. I'm not going to say never, but there's a lot of other games out there that are probably going to get a game of the year for 2016. Like No Man's Sky, you know what I mean? That game's going to have a hell of a lot of players, and it's going to be probably pretty amazing. Okay, so what's next here? Okay, it should be cool. So enemies should be able to target him. Should be able to target Jib. And we can get rid of this too. We don't need this old code. Right. Oh yeah, it could be. Could be. You never know. Oh, I know what this is. It's in target behavior. Target. This is if target. If der. Here we go. Setting a target. Here, nearest friend. Let's see what happens when he sets target nearest friend. So there needs to be, so this says target the nearest friend. So what this guy needs is to be able to forget his current target and start targeting something else. Really? I never would have thought people would doubt No Man's Sky. That one looks really good. What else is coming out in 2016 that's freaking looks awesome? Well, hopefully Hyper Light Drifter comes out. I've been looking forward to that one for a while. That's more like the indie scene. Cuphead? I've seen this one before, but I forgot which one this is. Oh yeah, Cuphead game. Yeah, I really like the aesthetic of this one. This is cool. Heat signature? Chasm, yeah. Chasm, totally. Chasm looks awesome. Which one's Heat Signature? A game about sneaking aboard? Dot, dot, dot. How to make a great British bake-off game? No, this is not. This isn't it. Yeah. I like this idea. This is not a stupid idea. This is actually a cool idea. This might happen. Oh wait, oh dude, I'm playing a YouTube video. Sorry if this
Hello,
breaks
this
the
is Heat
stream.
Signature. It's a space stealth about boarding randomly generated ships. And I'm in this little pod here that's kind of glowing hot as I use my thrusters too much. And this is a randomly generated ship, and when I come up to its airlock, I dock with it and I go inside. And then you can sneak through its corridors, you can use its computers to
That's pretty
crack
cool.
open doors. How many hacks do I have? I've got two hacks. These two doors cost one each. Actually, no, I'm going to hack this one. So I spent a hack to open that one, and then I'm going to. They've lost one of their most valuable
Oh,
assets.
look at
If
that.
it says steal,
This is
then that
zoomed
means an
out
important piece of
Galaxy
technology has
View
been
or
taken
something.
across. I don't really know how it's going to. Doesn't it? And
Huh,
then what I
interesting
want to do.
idea for a game. Oh, The Witness. Oh, The Witness hasn't come out yet? I haven't even paid attention to The Witness, but I got mad respect for Jonathan Blow. Yeah, it is 2016. Okay, right, nice. How about this? How about every single frame? Or no, not every single frame. We can't do that. Yeah, let's just set target to be none more often. Like shield up. Or shield down, actually. Shield up and then down. We set target to none. Charge, we need a target. Seek. Stuck would be another great one to just. Oh, that's my. He might be really, really hard, is because he might have been getting stuck. Yeah, let's not do that. Here, set target to none here. Wander, Vran 2, Dur Ran, Speed 1, and also target none. There, so now you should be setting targets to none a bunch. Yeah, it's indivisible, huh? Indivis. Visible. I cannot type at all. Oh. Oh, right, yeah. The Skullgirls game. How long have they been crowdfunding? Holy crap, they're looking for 1.5 mil. Wow, okay, 16,000 backers. Good golly, Miss Molly. This is a high stakes one right here. Yeah, Indivisible. I've seen this one. Cool. They started 2 weeks ago? Intergalactic Race Warriors, huh? Whoa, what do they got here? This looks cool. Awesome. Well, yeah, looking forward to checking out more about that one too. Oh, yeah. Oh, cool. I will. Thanks, Rocket Bunny. I appreciate funny stuff to watch and all the cool stuff you guys are sharing. Like yesterday, Pedro sent some rad links. I checked out finally after the stream. Forget what it was, but it was cool when I watched it. Oh, really? Let's see if this works now. So this guy should now target none a bunch, and that means that he should target the... Once he gets a nun, he's going to target the nearest friend after that, which should make him able to attack Jib. Let's see if that happens. Thanks for following. So Jib doesn't even have a category, I don't think. Yeah, he doesn't even have a collision component. Oh man, this is easy enough. Okay, so Jib needs a collision component in the category friend. And size 0 or whatever. That actually probably is all I need right there, category friend. Yeah, very good question to ask here. Early access. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I am going to echo Boogie's sentiment here. I'm the exact same. Like, if I buy the game and it's early access, I'll be also afraid that I probably wouldn't complete it or play it once it's finished. But that also depends on how much replayability there is in the game, you know? Okay, so now he has a collision category. He should have no size. I wonder what happens if a collision component is created with no size. Yeah, okay, we can get a category, no prob. Mask, 0 by default. Damage, 0 by default. Mask, 0 by default. Flags, nothing. Parse block size. Oh, by the way, you guys, I did add block sizes. So, like, this was yesterday's stream. We were talking about this, of doing, like, a size like that based on block sizes. So it does work. I could put B's next to sizes, and that makes them based on a block size.
rather than pixels. So that's going to be real handy. I love this. This is a great suggestion. Thank you, J2. J2, I think, suggested this, right? We're suggesting doing a... Yeah, he did. Thanks again, J2, if you're still watching the stream. Yeah, I've heard of this one. Yeah. Yeah, right? Yes, it's totally swappable with pixels. So yeah, if like, this is great for somebody that's writing mods for the game, they can set their own block size for the game, like whatever your block size you want. And then, yeah, you can either specify the equivalent of that in pixels would be like 0.75 would be like, you know, like 15 pixels by like 9 pixels by whatever 30 pixels, so that these two would be equivalent exactly. Really, all this does is just convert it into pixels based on whatever the block size is. So that's cool. Yeah, they're awesome people, right? Bit of Barnett, you've seen their talks, right? You've seen the talks their talk on feel, game feel, and juiciness and all that, right? Cool, yeah. Yeah, nice. Yeah, everybody, Rocket Bunny's from the Netherlands, so he's right there with Lambeer. Wait, but what part of... Yeah, the screen shake talk, right? Rocket Bunny, what part of the Netherlands are you from? Are you from, well, I guess you don't have to answer that if you want, but yeah. Nice, right on. Yeah, okay, so you've seen those. Great, good. Just making sure, because that's freaking awesome videos everyone should see. Parse block size, is this... This can handle, like, zero, right? If... Vector string. Oh yeah, this could really use this. If stir.size has nothing, then return. That'll make that a little more safer. Okay, so now Jib should have a category now. Oh, right. It's a beautiful city though, right, Rocket Bunny? Man, I spent 2 weeks there when I was traveling one time and I loved it. Such a beautiful city, the canals. And I do admit that I spent a lot of time in coffee shops. I was like, I'm in Amsterdam. There's no other place in the world like this. I'm gonna go to coffee shops every day. And I was like reading Game of Thrones back then. Yeah, isn't it? It's a great city. Really, really awesome. Okay, well, let's see if that works. So now Jib should have no size, but he should have a category. So that should make him so enemies should be able to confine him. Yeah, story is a real good point to bring up regarding early access. Yeah. Great coffee too, right? No? Oh, dude, please send a link if you got it. All right, so Jib, yeah, he doesn't have a box or whatever. Yeah, look, he's trying to attack Jib now. They're just going at it. So now Jib needs to be able to get hurt. Get him, Jib. Distract that guy. I'll get him while he's fighting you. Whoa, now he's pissed. Oh, this is so awesome. This makes the game a lot more dynamic. But, and this definitely needs to be refined, of course. But, yeah. Oh. Finally, you're helping me, Jib. Fight stuff. Oh, cool. I'm gonna definitely check this out later on. And French fries, right? Yeah. Jib forever. He's getting handy now. How much time do we got left on the stream? Because I'd like to do a little animation where he gets hurt. Okay, we got a half an hour. Good. Let's make him get hurt now. So he can, like, get knocked down onto the ground and sort of, like, spark or something like that and then wake up. Sprites. Jib. Idle. Jib stash. Hey, right when you said that, we got a picture of the stash right here. I still need to make a stash version of Jib for these icons. Oh yeah, Light of Thief, this is concept art for the new psychedelic dungeon. Yeah, how do you like it? Anything I can make better? This is your spirit guide guy. He's gonna be a very interesting part of the story. So these psychedelic dungeons are places where you go and you gain abilities and stuff. And they're a lot different than regular dungeons. And the theme is supposed to sort of look like it's underwater. Nice. Good, man. Yeah. Yes, good, man. Good, Buddha Barney. This is awesome. I'm really glad that you're getting to that point. I know it is. It's super scary to share your stuff, especially when you haven't done it before, but getting over that sooner rather than later is awesome. And understanding the psychology of why you are scared is really going to help you, right? Like, so if you spend some time like soul searching and being like, okay, why is it that I'm actually scared to share my game? And you get real honest about that, you'll realize those motivations you have psychologically. And once you've realized what they are, you're one step away from conquering that fear, you know? So I hope that helps too. Yeah. There's this one. This one is not supposed to have a lot of grass on it, but there's another concept sort of one with a lot more grass on it. Dungeon psychedelic. Yeah, so this kind of shows that there is more grass in it. So, and this is all kind of rough. I didn't really make, you know, I didn't spend much time drawing more rocks and stuff, but okay, so let's work on Jib and get him to be able to be hurt. Oh, that's a cool idea. Yeah. Yeah, I think maybe I'll be working on that sometime it might be December before I can work on that, because at some point pretty soon I've got to lock the code down and make the demo ready for the December 10th Indie Cup. All right, yeah, so let's draw something where he can get hurt, and then yeah, nice, cool. Yeah, I was definitely thinking about you and your advice and everything when I drew this. You know, I was like, okay, I got to make this thing the right perspective. So I drew it like as really as wide on top as I could to give it that correct perspective. Yeah, deadlines, right? Deadlines. Hooray. That was the Archer hooray. Hooray. Okay, let's save this as Yeah, Chiro's jib hurt. Oh, yeah, you know what? I probably will. I'll probably do that. In fact, I might as well, if I'm going to create a demo, I might as well update the alpha version and just have everyone that already has access to the alpha get another updated version of the game. You know, it's going to take me at least 2 weeks to get it ready, you know, just to work out any bugs and stuff. But that will be really cool to get that, you know, get that stuff worked out. And it would definitely help to have you guys check it out. So I will definitely do that. Oh, right. Yeah. Rocket Bunny. Yeah. 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 Totally. Yep. Your friends will be less honest with you than you'd want to, especially with things you create, you know. I mean, that doesn't apply to all friends. I'm sure some friends, but, you know. Yeah, definitely. The more you do art the right way, the more it becomes easy and natural. All right. So, let's see. He gets hurt. Gets knocked down to the ground. He's facing east. So I think he's going to get knocked down to the left. Yeah. Yeah, I'm thinking actually I'll do most of the story at the very end of this project so that I can get all the most important game behaviors and mechanics and everything finished first and then add all the story at the very end so that people that are playing the alpha and the beta versions can be surprised when the game finally is complete and the story is all added. So that's, you know, that's to kind of make it so there. I won't have to do as many spoiler alerts, like, you know, so I'll do all that development at the end. How do you post your GIFs on Twitter? You just post them on Twitter, man. You just post an image. It's pretty easy. These other versions, yeah, this is fine. We can do this. What's this? That was a party hat I added, but didn't draw very well. What's this? Oh, that was some shading for the party hat. Yeah, he needs this though. Okay, so he's gonna get hit from the right side, and he's gonna fall down here to the left. Oh yeah, it is. It is pretty bad, and it's limited to 3 megs. So why do you say 506? Yeah. Oh. Oh, 560. Yeah. A Shadow Rock. You know what? I've thought about that, like from like Zelda 2, yeah. And I think it would be pretty cool, but I don't know. I'm open to thoughts. What are you guys' thoughts? Would it be cool if you had a rock that's like a dark rock version, and you have to fight yourself, basically? A gym mug shot. Oh, well, you're going to have to, this is something, it kind of depends. There's lots of ways to combine pings into GIFs. What system are you on? Yeah, possibly. That would make a lot of sense, yeah, in the trippy dungeons. All right, so let's get another frame. And we'll get him to, like, get hit. And let's get some sparks or something. Yeah, I don't know what system you're on, but on If you're on Mac or Linux, it's really easy to create GIFs using, man, what the hell is the command I use to make them? Whoops. GIF. What the heck? Man, no, not man. There. I'm using the convert command. Here, I'll post this if in case this is the command I use. It's the convert command, and maybe this helps you. Oh, this is hard. Proton Gaming, almost done with the game? Nope. Sorry, man. It's gonna be another year. Not a whole another year, but like another 6 months at least before this game's done. All right, so there's one frame. That's so dirty. Here's another frame. Yeah, Proton, I am. Yeah, so yeah, the Kickstarter, I was thinking that it would take till December, right? Ne so that would be next month that I would release it, right? But then since the Kickstarter hit its goal of its second or its first what do you call them? Stretch goals. It hit its first stretch goal of having local multiplayer. So that means that the game, I announced this already, that the game would take, probably another 3 months at least. And now I'm also a little bit behind that. So that would have been releasing the game in March. And now I'm thinking maybe more like, maybe June. I don't know. So, but regardless, I'd rather make this a really awesome game and have it take a little bit longer than to release a half-assed game or release an early access game or whatever. So I don't know how I'm gonna find the funds to continue developing this, but I think it'll work out somehow. Nice, Rocket Bunny, cool, I'm glad. So here he's on the ground, and his eye goes dark. This light on top of his head goes dark too. Jim, no, buddy. Yeah, definitely. That's pretty awesome, right? It's a good feeling. Right? Potluck. That actually is a possibility. I know a lot of you guys are great coders. But it would be crazy messed up, right? Yeah. All right, so he's on the ground, and then he wakes up after a little while. Oh, it'd be nice to give him two frames here. One frame, he's got his light on, so he can like blink in and out like that. Okay, so now he's gonna wake up. What made me want to re make games? Oh, just playing them, yeah. Yeah, playing games made me want to make games. Okay, get up, Jib. Actually, he was going to turn his light on and then rotate a little. Yeah, let's make him rotate a little bit on this frame here. The final boss's name is Wizard Fu. Not today, Jim. Yeah, really? Metal Slug did it for you? Rubbish art style. You know what? I bet you there that actually is an art style. What, and then he gets combined back into Big Jesus? Yeah, dude, I love you guys' ideas. These are great. Kind of weird and messed up here in this one, but oh well. These are intermediary frames. Oh, actually, we don't need this frame anymore. Oh, hey, we're ready to animate this. All right, see you, Pedro. Yeah, see you, Lime Studios. See you guys. Have a good time. Enjoy yourselves. Yeah, right. Yeah, I know. Mario Maker. That would have been, yeah. Oh, wow. Whoa, 300 images? Yeah, you gotta get good tools, man. Good tools are important. They'll make everything easier. All right, so he's here. He's gets hit. No, Jim. Falls on the ground. He blinks. Maybe he blinks twice. And then he's gonna sit here for a while, like maybe a whole second. And then you wake up. Yes, I like this old idea. I'm there in some cave streaming the making of this the same game you're playing. Oh, he's here. Isn't he? Boffo! Look, see, he's there. And he moves up a little bit. All right, let's see how this looks. Yeah, it might need a couple more frames at the end there. Nice. Nice, almost got that one flying. All right, let's try that again. Oh, he needs some light when he's getting hit. Right? All right, thief, see you, man. Good night. So this frame here needs a little bit, whoops, a little bit of glow. Yeah, something like that. I'm not exactly sure. But it's the same kind of tech that keeps those like the big balls floating, you know, the energy ball things and other enemies. This is a great question to wonder about. This is some nice lore. When I said that, I was like, "Looks great, kid." Okay, let's check it out now. They're attached to the moon. All right, I like it. I like it. This is good enough to try. Wait, actually. No, this one's a little too bright right here. Maybe more like that. Yeah, like it. You don't like it? You don't like it. This is not likable, not at all. Let's see what we can do, though, to put this in the game. If there's enough time. Is there enough time to do this? There, we got 4 minutes. There's enough time to try this. Hopefully. If I can code this up fast enough. Render video. Render this out, man. I don't want to wait all day. Put this in the Heroes folder. He floats on love. it was warm with no rain. Yeah, that's pretty much how it is every day here. Okay. Which is not very good. We need rain really bad. What's the heroine called? She's called Vel right now. Yeah. Like VELLE. Yeah, he called it. He called it for sure. Okay, how is Jib gonna get hurt? How is mechanically the game gonna make him get hurt? He doesn't have a hit. He doesn't have any hit points or anything right now. I guess we could do some. Yeah, I got a way to do it. Yeah. Yeah, I do. I gotta hurry, right? I gotta hurry. Okay, good. So, mood jib. Let's make him. I'll do some really simple collision detection without having to do any collision detection. Right? So if his target, look at the target, move towards the target. Actually, all this. This is his distance squared to the target. We already got that. Perfect. So, get hurt by enemies. If target dot collision. Autocomplete category. K filter. Foe. And we're really close. And distance squared. It's like less than really close would be like 40 or 50. Let's try 40 for now. Okay, here's where he's gonna get hurt. So he's not gonna move. Really, all he needs to do is run his animation for getting hurt. So we need to hook that animation up. Animations, give him this hurt animation, hurt. Make sure that's the right file name format. Yeah, heroes jib hurt. 29 frames. Okay, cool. Hurt. He's got hurt. Now run this animation. After we're done, he can wake up and do his idle. And make sure this thing cannot be overridden, ridden. Ridden. Okay, render enims overridable. Oh, render enim overridable. doesn't like auto-completing with a squiggly in front. Yeah, overwritable. There, so now, if he's hurt, if e.render.animation, animation equals hurt, return, don't anything. See if this works. Internet shuts off in 2 minutes. Yes, yes. So yeah, well, that's how I did it. You see how I did it? I just basically checked if he's close to his entity. All right, so if this works, he'll fall over if he gets really close to an enemy. And he should stay on the ground for a minute. Oh, it didn't work. Oh, come on, Jib. Well, how about, let's do this. Let's see if this is even working. It'll make millions? Yeah, it's working fine. I think it's working fine. All right, yeah, I need to see one more time the breakpoint there. Make sure that it is actually returning, and then I'll keep a breakpoint here. So we'll see what happens the next time. Oh, you know what? I just realized this needs this. If render.animation is not equal to hurt. Come on. Come on, Jib. Get knocked over. Get back up, buddy. Get back up. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it, little buddy. He's already getting hurt. He's like, oh, yeah, I'm hurt. Guy's not even visible yet. Yes. I do want to at least, if this works, it'd be so cool for us to share this moment of it working. So set the animation to hurt. Make sure we got another breakpoint, so this runs again. Return. And next time. Oh, see that? What's his animation this time? This is probably what's going on. If you're quiet, you can stay in the store while the store is still open. So it forgot all about this animation, looks like. Idle. Oh, or the herd animation had 0 frames. Oh. Well, let's see if it does have any frames. Da, na, 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 na. No completions? Give me a break. Oh, it's a render system. Render system, get animation. There it is. All right, so I'm gonna see what happens when if this animation is even loading, then this will work. All right, Boogie, see you, man. Let's see. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Set the animation and then step into this. Oh yeah, it's fine. It looks like it had. Oh no, it's not fine. Total delay units 0. Okay, well here's our problem. Yeah, so there's no frames in this animation. That's obviously the problem here. But the key is all right. Did I do that right? Jib hurt. Jib hurt. But yeah, that should load fine. Yeah, we have Thanksgiving. Yep, so next week I won't be streaming next weekend because it'll be Thanksgiving weekend. I'll be with family. Family time. Okay, one last time I'm gonna run the game and see if this can be fixed. Something simple, I'm sure. It's just not playing this animation when he gets here. Yeah, Thanksgiving. Oh yeah, I don't know. I couldn't figure it out right now. For some reason, I think this animation has no frames. Yeah, I know this animation has no frames, but I don't know why. So I guess I'll have to figure this out after the stream. Whoa, oh my God, really? Dang, dude. Oh, I'm glad they checked. I'm really glad they checked. And let's hope there's not much of that nonsense in the future. Okay, everybody. Well, that's it for today's stream. Sorry I couldn't get this working, but there is a cool animation drawn for Jib so he can get hurt. He falls on the ground and I'm not sure if he'll be invincible or he'll have hit points. I'm not sure exactly yet. But yeah, see you guys. Yeah, stay safe, have fun, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for joining. Yeah, appreciate you all. Yeah. Later, guys.